I always think that the secret to setting a beautiful table is really about putting interest in front of your guests. And of course, there has to be harmony in terms of a color story, a palette, and a sensibility, especially to keep everything looking really tailored and well-made. But I do think that the wow factor, once people come into a room, into a dining room, is so important. The drama of setting a table is so important. It doesn't have to be over the top, but I think a moment, you know, to be able to romance a room and a table and allow people to feel that moment of, which is so exciting. And the thought that it took, you know, in order to set a table for your friends, for your family, is really something very special. One of the things that I feel is lacking in the world is an attention to detail of beautiful products made for the home. I think that fashion is really saturated, but where are the brands that talk about home in a beautiful way, in an artisanal way, and also in a handmade way? It is inspiring to be in a culture where wherever you look, you see beauty. And it inspires me to create, to think about all the different textures that we have in our collections, in a different way. I think that Tuscany itself is just an amazing place for beautiful colors, whether it's ceramics or the vegetation here, the frescoes, everything that you see around me, or that one sees around themselves, is an incredible inspiration to all the different layers that I bring to my collection. So today, I wanted to share a blue and white table. Everybody loves blue and white, and now as we go into the spring and summer months, blue and white is super fresh and light. It is agreeable also to, I think, so many different cultures. So once you've laid down this a beautiful tablecloth, which really is a layering piece, and it could be white or it could be a bright color, Then it's lovely to put a beautiful placemat on top. Now, I personally love our rounds. You can have more people around a table with a round. Then we set the plates. And this is actually a question that a lot of people have, which is, do we set the table with the plates or do we not set the table with the plates? Depending upon how much space you have with your kitchen and the food preparation, it does make sense to probably serve at the table so that people also are participating in serving themselves. I love passing a platter around and people taking their own portions. Some people like more, some people I like less, and so I prefer to set the table with the plates. Here we have our dinner plate and our pasta bowl. And I think that a napkin right in the middle is just so charming. And now we're going to set the cutlery. We have our dinner knife on the right, dinner fork on the left, with your salad fork sitting next to your dinner fork. And of course, let us not forget the teaspoon or the dessert spoon at the top. And for our glasses, it's nice to have your water glass in the far side, and then to layer with your white wine as well as your red wine. It's nice to have a triangle where you go, where you have the smallest glass in front, then sitting next to the taller glasses in the rear. And lastly, we have our bread basket, which I am lining with a simple white coaster, placing it on the left side of the placemat, and voila, you have a beautiful table setting